exercise we have completed till question number 3 of exercise 2.2. Now we are beginning with the question number 4. Question is, find the product using suitable properties. Find the product using suitable properties. So students, what we are supposed to do, just to see over here. Okay, first question is 738 multiplied by 103. 738 multiplied by 103. So how can we find the product of these two numbers, right? Just have a look here. Okay, can I write 103 student as 100 plus 3? Can I write 103 as 100 plus 3? Now just have a look here. Right, we can write here, right students? Now what can we do? We can multiply 738 with the 100 and 738 with the 3. So 738 multiplied by 100, then 738 multiplied by 3, right? So 738 multiplied by 100, students, it is 73800. 738 multiplied by 3, so we can get 3 8s are 24, 3 3s are 9, plus 2 11, 21 plus 2 22. Now just add them. So 4, 1, 8 plus 2, it is 10. 1 plus 3, 4, plus 2, 6. 76,014. 76,014 is your answer, students, right? Now taking the second question, that is 854 multiplied by 102. Here also, students, I can write 102 as 100 plus 2. Students, I can write 102 as 100 plus 2. See, the property which we have used here, student, that is a distributive property, right? Distributive property says that distribution of multiplication over addition. That means aapko jo product hai, distribute karna padega usko, right? And then you have to add them. So here, so 854 multiplied by 100. So first I am going to multiply them. 854 with the 100, then 854 with the 2. So 854 multiplied by 100 plus 854 multiplied by 2. So 854 multiplied by 100, students, it is 85400 plus, now 854 multiplied by 2. So 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 is 16 plus 1 17. So it is 8, then 0, then 4 plus 7, it is 11, 1 plus 5 6 plus 1 7, and it is 8. So the answer is, students, 87,108. So the answer is 87,108. It is not necessary, students, that here you can get the addition operation only, but here you can get a minus operation, that means subtraction operation also, but depending on the numbers. See, here the number is 102. So 102 we can write as 100 plus 2, students, right? And now if in case of 102, if the number would be 98, so in that case you cannot do 100 plus 2. So in that case you have to go back. So you have to write as 100 minus 2. Now taking the, students, the third question, 258 multiplied by 1008. So can I write, students, 1008 as 1000 plus 8? Yes, I can write 1008 as 1000 plus 8. Now multiply 258 with the 1000. Multiply 258 with the 8. So 258 multiplied by 1000 plus 258 multiplied by 8. Right? So 258 multiplied by 1000, students, 258000, right? Now simultaneously 258 with the 8, so 8 8s are 64, 6 8 5 is a 40, plus 6 46, 16 plus 4 20. So we need to add them. So 4 6 0, 8 plus 2 it is 10, so 1 plus 5 it is 6 and 2. So the answer is, students, that is 2,60,064. 2,60,064 is the answer. Moving to the fourth one, students. See here, the numbers are 1005 into 168. 1005 into 168. So can we write 1005 as 1000 plus 5? Can we write as 1005 as 1000 plus 5? It is not necessary, students, that this kind of operation can be only done with the second number. It can also be done on the first number also, right? Even you can split up 168 also as 100 plus 68 or 160 plus 8. But try to choose the numbers in such a manner that your multiplication task is reduced. If you split up this one, so your multiplication task will be doubled, right? Then you can say, okay, madam, directly multiply, that will be quite easier. So here I am choosing 1005. So I am writing 1005. Even you can reverse the numbers also. You can reverse it like that, 168 multiplied by 1005. That is also okay. See, I am reversing for all of you. Is it okay? Right? Doesn't mean ki aap 1005 ko hamesha aage rakho ya piche rakho. Right? You should know how to work. That's it. So 1005 I can write as 1000 plus 5. Now 168 multiplied by 1000 and 168 multiplied by 5. So 168 multiplied by 1000. Plus operation, 168 multiplied by 5. So 168 multiplied by 1000 is 168,000 plus 168 multiplied by 5. So 5 8s are 40, 5 6s are 30 plus 4 34, 5 1s are 5 plus 3. So 8. So now we need to add them. So we'll get 168,840 as the answer. So the answer is, students, that is 1,68,840 is your answer. I hope, students, you understood this question number 4. Okay, students, now let's see the question number 5. That is, a taxi driver filled his car petrol tank with 40 liters on Monday. That means on Monday, the taxi driver filled his petrol tank with 40 liters of petrol. That means Monday ko 40 liters petrol unhone apne petrol tank mein dalwaya. Next one is, the next day, he filled the tank with 50 liter of petrol. Next day, that means Tuesday, the taxi driver has filled the tank with 50 liters of petrol, right? So overall, if you see, the students, 40 on Monday and 50 on Tuesday. So overall, 90 liters of petrol the taxi driver has filled. Now, what is the cost of 1 liter of petrol? If the petrol cost rupees 44 per liter, how much did he spend in all on the petrol? Now this is quite an easy question. You can even say, ma'am, 90 multiplied by 44 will get the answer, right? But let's do this same answer using some different method, right? Students, you can have the changes in the figure in the textbook, so you can do accordingly, right? As far as my textbook is concerned, I am having these figures with me. If you have change in your textbook, then you can go along with that. So see the solution here, students, that is, see, 40 on Monday and 50 on Tuesday, right? So this is the format, multiply by how much is the cost for 1 liter, that is 44. Agar aap Monday ka bhi calculation karenge, students, separately, so aapko 44 into 50, 40 karna padega. Aur Tuesday ka karenge to 44 into 50 karna padega. That means 44 is a common for both the days. That means 44 rupees is common for both the days, right? So let's see the calculation, students. 44 into 40 and 44 into 50. Okay, 44 fours are, students, it is 1760, right? And 44 fives are 0 for this. 5 fours are 20. 20 plus 2, 22, right? So the total amount that the taxi driver is spending on the petrol is, so I can write here, total amount spent on petrol. Is it clear? Okay, one thing is missing here, that is a rupee sign. So rupees 3960. So this is the total amount that the taxi driver is spending on the petrol. Rupees 3960. Okay, students, now let's see the question number 6. That is, a vendor supplies 32 liters of milk to a hotel in the morning. Vendor means the person who is supplying the milk, right? So how much liters of milk he is supplying in the morning to a hotel? That is 32 liters, right? Similarly, he is supplying 68 liters of the milk in the evening. That means in the morning 32, in the evening 68. So if you see that overall day, so overall day, agar aap ek day ki ka dekhenge, so in all the vendor is giving 100 liters of milk every day. 32 in the morning, 68 in the evening. Add them, you will get 100 liters of milk, right? So every day the vendor is giving 100 liters of milk to the hotel. Now, if the milk cost is rupees 15 per liter, so if the milk, the cost of milk is 15 rupees per liter, how much money is due to the vendor per day, right? So we need to find that how much the vendor needs to collect from the hotel. So okay, students, now let's see the calculations here. See, the vendor is giving 32 in the morning, 68 in the evening, right? And both the milk are of the same price, that means 15 rupees, right? So how to solve it? First we'll add them. You can even multiply them, 15 with the 32, 15 with the 68. But why to increase the calculations? So 15 multiplied by 32 plus 68, it is 100. So 1500 rupees the vendor needs to collect. Vendor needs to collect from hotel. Is it clear, students? So this much is the amount that the vendor needs to collect from the hotel on a daily basis. Daily basis. This much is the amount. I hope, students, you understood this question. Okay, students, now let's see the last question of this exercise, that is question number 7. Match the following, right? First question into it, that is 425 multiplied by 136 is equal to 425 multiplied by, see, they have split this 136, that means when I break kiya, 136 square is 6 plus 30 plus 100. If you add them, you will get 136 only, students, right? Now, here they just want to, they just want from us that this particular statement is of which properties, right? Commutativity under multiplication, commutativity under addition, distributivity of multiplication over addition. So this question, student, this statement is of this last property, that is distributivity of multiplication over addition, because here they are, if you want to solve them, then you need to distribute the multiplication. So first one, the correct answer for the first one is C. So you can write here also 1, or you can write here also as a C. So I am writing here as C. Right? Now next one is, students, 2 into 49 into 50. Right? Now here they are only just changing the place. So 2 multiplied by 50 into 49. Actually here there are 3 numbers. Right? So as per the properties, the 3 numbers should be of the associative properties, and that too the only multiplication is there, right? So let's see the 2 remaining properties, commutativity under multiplication, commutativity under addition. Which operation here, student? That is multiplication. Actually here it should be associative, but here they are given as a commutative, so we have to go with the textbook only. So commutativity under multiplication will be the correct answer for this. So I am writing here A. Okay. Now just to see the last one, students. 80 plus 2005 plus 20 is equal to 80. Just they are changing the place. 20 plus 2005. So this is of which property? That is commutativity under addition. So here I am writing B. Is it okay, students? I hope you will you got this entire exercise 2.2. आभार